Hi everyone, we are here at Thomann in Treppendorf. My very first slap bass line I learned was Never Too Much from Luther Vandross, played by Marcus Miller. And now he's sitting next to me. It's like dream come true. So it's a great, great honor to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
I played that song for about, I think, 3 months because I just started.
Oh, wow.
Just that song.
It's a cool song.
But it is awesome. Also, the second song my teacher showed me, it was, I think it was released in 1983. Could It Be You? Fretless bass. It's like... When I first heard that, I think I cried a little bit because of the solo part. It's like I've never heard this before because there were just four bars, just a groove, and then you start
then
your solo line.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
How did you get to that point? Because a lot of people and also young musicians, just when there's a solo, we start playing like a lot and right at the time. And you, at such a young age, you just feel it. And the first line, the melody, it was so smooth and everything.
Well, you know, when I was 19, I'm playing with Roberta Flack. Did you ever hear of Roberta Flack?
Of course.
Don't say of course. People of your age, you'd be amazed what they don't know. But anyway, I'm glad you've heard of her because she was a master at silence, right? She would go the first time. Ever I saw your face. And I was playing in a band and playing whole notes because I'm the bass player, so I'm going, first time. And I'm watching the audience. I'm watching people react. And the silence was killing them as much as the notes were killing them because it makes you anticipate, you know? It makes you tune in. So I was in Roberta's band, and then Roberta fired me. I said, why are you firing me? She says, because you're too expensive. You and Luther Vandross are too expensive. Get out. She was like, she was like our mom, you know what I mean? And she was like, I see you doing great things. I see you producing music. I see you playing with Miles Davis. And I laughed. I said, look, you can fire me without having to promise me that I'm going to be playing with Miles Davis. He hasn't played a note in 6 years. A year later, Miles called me. And I'm on the stage with Miles, and I'm watching him do the same thing with that silence. He would stand there, and the band would be playing, and he'd just be... And he'd play the note, you know what I mean? And it made everybody go... Now, it's harder to do that with the bass because if the bass starts playing, there's nothing else going on, you know, except the beat. So it's difficult to really create that kind of space. So what I would do instead, I'd start with the bass line, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And I'd go like... Bass line and soloing, you know what I mean? Bass line, so that's my space, going back to the bass line, you know? sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes I'm not in the mood to leave all that space.
Mm-hmm, of course.
And I'll come out blazing, you know what I mean? But I'm always trying to tell a story, and I'm always trying to make what I play appropriate. Have you ever seen like a band with improvisation, and the guitar player plays a solo, he's finished his solo, and then the sax player, you know, starts his own solo as if the guitar player never existed. Like, you know, the guitar player goes, he tells a story, he goes, once upon a time, right? Mm-hmm. And then he's playing, and you know, and then that's how blah, 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 he's finished. And then the sax player goes, once upon a time, you know, and he starts, who wants to hear like five once upon a times? You know what I mean? Yeah. It might be nice if you say, you know what happened after that? You know, part chapter two of this story, you know, like the sequel is this, you know what I mean? Like, take it into account what the other person played. So a lot of people say, man, why are you playing the slap solo? Because usually the bass plays last. If there is a bass solo, it comes last. And there have been so many melodic solos that, of course, I can play a melodic solo, but there's no contrast. It's no interest, you know what I mean? Especially, you know, if you're playing with like Herbie Hancock and some, you know, Mike Stern, some great musicians, I'm gonna do something that they haven't done yet. Yeah. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna come live. And then Herbie's going, oh, shucks. You know? It's a nice contrast. What I'm doing is I'm giving up my opportunity to play melodically because I think the music benefits from maybe a more rhythmic thing. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe me and the drummer can get into something, you know. And overall, you know, I might get tagged as just a rhythmic bass player, but overall the music works, you know. So I'm cool with that.
But you're a melodic player, like Could It Be You? There are so many beautiful lines in it.
So with playing melodies, usually like I use a really sparse extra bass, like a keyboard player playing.
Or if I'm making a second record. Bass player in your band. Seen that. And do you still have like practice routines, or did you ever had like practice routines?
I didn't spend a lot of time going on. Actually, I did. I had spent a lot of time doing that, especially early on. But these days, like I was just going. And I just came up with that, but because we were talking, I didn't want to play too loud. So I put my forearm on the E string, right? So because that was an accident, you know, it's not an accident, but something I wasn't thinking about, I go, wait a minute, that's kind of nice.
Cool.
So I improvise when I'm, you know, first I just start playing, maybe I'll come up with something interesting and then make a routine out of it to practice so I can maybe incorporate it, you know?
And how do you do the, like the beginning of Power, it's like, I think, a double thumb. Mm-hmm. Also play with double?
Sometimes, yeah. Just for the energy at a certain point in your solo when you need to like take it up a notch, throw that in there because it sounds like it's energy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't usually walk in the door with a solo with that, you know what I mean?
Start with this line.
Yeah. There was a bass player He's actually a guitar player. His name was Eric Gale. And Eric Gale was a great guitarist, did a lot of sessions with Aretha Franklin and Grover Washington Jr. back in the day. And Eric played great guitar, but he also played bass from time to time. And he had an old, old Kramer bass. Mm-hmm. And he had strings that he hadn't changed in probably 7-10 years, right? And he played with a pick, so it had a very distinctive sound. And he was a guitar player, so he wasn't really that concerned with downbeats.
Okay.
So the beat would be like, here you go. I'm like, what are you gonna play a downbeat, you know? But anyway, a friend of mine, a producer named Ralph McDonald, he said, I was young, I was like 19, and he goes, you hear that sound? That's a real bass, you know? And I said, you like that? He goes, yeah, man, that's the real thing right there. So I said, I can do that, you know? So next time he called me for a session and Eric was playing guitar, mm-hmm. you know, I started playing like, you know, yeah, that's a real bass. That sounds real, you know. So I'm like, okay, you like that. That sounds corny to me, but you like it, okay. But then I started working with a singer, Luther Vandross. He's a good friend of mine. He was in Roberta Flack's band with me when I was there. And he decided he wanted to try it out as a solo artist. So he did a demo. And we started making music for him. And his music was so gentle. I said, you know that funny thing that I came up with for Ralph McDonald? That might work. Luther loved it because it was so fat and it just supported the track, you know? Yeah. And plus, because I'm playing all downstrokes, I can't play too fast.
Yeah.
So it makes you be economical. It makes you kind of think like a old school bass player.
Yeah,
you
know, not play too much.
Not playing too much.
Yeah.
And I like that because it slowed me down. It made me think about not all the notes, just the right notes. So that became an important thing and I use it still, you know? And then when I'm playing straight ahead jazz, I never liked the sound. So you can use that in a lot of different ways. So that became part of my thing too.
Wow. Thank you so much for all the answers. And you're going to have the tour now, the summer tour, Europe summer tour, mm-hmm. with a lot of dates I saw in July.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, I know that we're starting in France and I know we're going to
Italy.
Yeah.
I saw and Spain, Budapest. Maybe?
Budapest, yeah. That's where we're going, yeah. Thank you, you know better than me. I just know I have to show up for the first date and then just go where the band goes.
Nice. Thank you so much
All
for
right.
being here.
My pleasure, thank you.
Nice.
Four. All right.